गुड मॉर्निंग सेवन्थ क्लास, हाउ आर यू? फाइन ऑफ कोर्स, यस क्लास. डे बिफोर यस्टरडे वी स्टार्टेड द टॉपिक वर्ब्स एंड यू नो वेरी वेल दैट वर्ब्स आर डूइंग, बीइंग एंड पोजेसिंग वर्ड्स. डूइंग मीन्स एनी एक्शन, बीइंग मीन्स स्टेट ऑफ बीइंग, पोजेसिंग मीन्स वन समबडी और समथिंग हैज. For example, doing, I am writing a letter, means action of writing is being done. Then she is a girl, he is a boy. Then it is the state of boy and girl, it is the state of being, is verb. Then I have a car, you have a pencil. Then I have or has, it is the possession, means what something I have, what something you have. So these are verbs. So writing, is, has, they all are verbs. So verbs are doing words also, verbs are being words also, and verbs are possessing words also. The verb may be one word, it may be two, it may be more than two. Just as I write, write is verb. Then I am writing, am writing, two words are there. Then I have been writing, more than two verbs. Clear? So the verbs are doing, being and possessing words. Also we have done irregular and irregular verbs. Regular verbs are those which take suffix D or ED with them. See on number 2 on the top. Hope, hoped, hoped. Stay, stayed, stayed. Want, wanted, wanted. Jump, jumped, jumped. Means that take D or ED with them. In past and past participle form. And when we talk about irregular verbs, in irregular verbs, the word is totally changed. Just as eat, at, eaten, go, went, gone, lose, lost, lost, right? This thing we have done. We have done verbs, regular and irregular verbs. Then after we do many verbs with their past, past participle and present participle form. The next phase also we have done. It was present, past, past participle and present participle form of the verb. The first form is called present. The second is called past. The third is called past participle. And the fourth one is given, it is present participle. Right? Now see, next, on the next page, see what I have done. On the top also, it is the forms of the verb. They are present, past and past participle. It is do, did, done, doing. Outdo, outdid, outdone, outdoing. Pay, paid, paid, paying. Repay, repaid, repaid, repaying. Set, 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 setting. Upset, 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 upsetting. Spell, spelt, spelt, spelling. Misspell, misspelt, misspelt, misspelling means wrong spelt. Then you come the correct usage. Study the use of the following verbs. See, the word is given, the verb is born, born. When bear means to bring forth, the past participle is born. And when it means to carry, the past participle is born, B-O-R-N-E. See the example. Jawaharlal Nehru was born on 14th November 1889. The wounded were born to the hospital. So B-O-R-N-E, born, it is to carry, and B-O-R-N, born, means it is the to bring forth, right? Now hanged and hung. It is the past and past participle of hang. When hang means to put a person to death by hanging, its past tense or past participle tense is hanged, H-A-N-G-E-D. But when it is used in other sense, in past tense or past participle tense, then it is hung, just as we hung the picture on the wall. See in the example also, the hangman hanged the murderer. The murderer was hanged. Means it is for the person who has committed some sin and due to that he has been hanged. Then I hung the painting on the wall. If we talk about some picture, then it is hung, H-U-N-G. The painting was hung on the wall. They both are the past and past participle form of hang. Hang, hanged, hanged. Hang, hung, hung. Clear? Okay. Now see lie and lay. To lie has two different sets of forms. When it means to say untrue things, not true, then it is lie. And the forms are lie, lied, lied. When it means to rest, then the forms are lie, lay, lain. If for untrue thing, then it is lie, lied, lied. And when it is for rest, then it is lie, lay, lain. He lied to me. He has lied to me. Means he has spoken something untrue things to me. And the second one, to the patient lay awake the whole night. He has lain down to rest, means to lay, to rest. In the last C, to lay means to put or place something down or produce eggs. Please lay the table. The hen has laid an egg. Clear? Okay. Now see, try to fill some blanks with the form. See on the next page. See here. Rewrite the following sentences by using the past tense of the verbs given in the brackets. Past means second form of the verb we have to fill. Clear? Present is the first form of the verb. Past is the second form of the verb. He dashed his brother yesterday, and in the bracket it is beat. The form is beat, beat. He beat his brother yesterday. The cracker, in the bracket it is given burst. The form is also burst. The cracker burst. The third, the injured man dashed to death, and the word is bleed. The second form is bled, B-L-E-D. The injured bled to death. A wasp dashed him. It is given sting. The second form is stung, S-T-U-N-G. Then it is a wasp stung him. He dashed nothing. Bracket is mean, the form. Then it is meant. He meant nothing. I dash him a blow. The bracket word is deal. Then it is dealt. I dealt him a blow. The wind blew hard. The form of blow is blue. Grow grew. Wear worn. Hang. It is the picture on number 10. You see he dash the picture. Then the second form is hung. H-U-N-G. He dash under a tree. Lie. Then what will you have to do? To rest. Then it is lay. L-A-Y. Lay. Then an idea strike. Then second form struck. Lay. Then lead, led. Clear to everyone? I think it is clear to you. I shall send you a PDF also so that you can read and you can do. Thank you. Have a nice day. Bye.